this is India, man. It has its own palette, it has its own people, and India is not going to change for anybody. They have to change for India.
Press the bell icon and never miss an update from Digital Hash.
Rose has been evolving with time. We started off with films, then we got into television, then we came back to films in a big way, and then we stayed away from films for a little time now, and now we've moved on to the streaming platforms now, because it's just the format of telling stories. You know, the platforms keep on changing from big screen to small screen to smart TVs to mobile phones, and it could be any format, and if we have a story to tell, we try and put it together and put it out there. The term producer is a little misunderstood in India. When I am producing a project, I direct also sometimes. I write most of them, So I don't know about other production houses and producers, but mine is a creative production house. We did larger than life films. We were one of the first few production houses to do fantasy movies with a lot of VFX. Hence, all my stories that I have to say are a little different from the rest. Kehne Ko Humsafar Hai was actually Ekta's brainchild, and Ekta and Shrishti are very good friends. Ekta actually reached out with the story idea, which was by Ms. Nina Gupta. And then Shrishti and Ekta got together on that, and they put together the script. My contribution to that particular project was mostly from a production finance point of view, and also from a point of view where I wanted a different kind of sensibility of technicians working on that show, because that show in particular, we were very concerned that it looked like typical television, which is not a bad thing, but it's just that you're going on a new platform, you want the story to be said in a different way. Ekta is a very intelligent woman, and she wanted to probably blend both the aesthetics, her storytelling powers with our aesthetics, And I think the outcome was supreme, It was, I think, the biggest blockbuster. And there's a season 2 coming out, and this time we are collaborating with Balaji on that. It's a good product. Unfortunately, they have not been officially announced. I'm not allowed to talk about it as yet, but there's a lot of excitement coming up this year, and hopefully you'll see at least multiple projects from Rose this year. We are focusing only on the streaming platforms now. We're not focusing on films, we're not focusing on television at all, or regular GECs. Our strategy is to just focus on the streaming platforms, I think, because that's where I can give my maximum, having done a long form and serialized content. And I think this streaming is a bit of both, where the preparations of a film, but the execution and the logistics is of television. So you've got to do a bit of both and walk a very tight rope on this. I find it very exciting to do remakes and book adaptations. I actually enjoy it, a lot of people don't, but I really do, because you get some material, and then I'm somebody who can really add nuances and take it to another level, I hope. We've just finished a project for Applause. That is an adaptation of a book by Novo Neil Chakravarti, Marry Me Stranger. It's in fact a trilogy, and you're writing the fourth part as we speak. And we had great fun adapting Novo Neil's book, Marry Me Stranger, and we've added a lot of stuff which is not there in the book, and taken it to a more visual platform. And Novo Neil has been part of the story development, and together we've managed to do a great job on it, I feel. Books will be made into series more than films, because books have far more detail, in which a series, it gives you the time to say that story in its true form. There's a lot more detail that you can tell in a series than, unfortunately, because of the running time limit, you can't say in a feature length film. I think that, you know, if it is not homegrown, then the Western people will make it homegrown as well. The classic example is McDonald's selling aloo tikki burger. So this is India, man. It has its own palate, it has its own people. And India is not going to change for anybody. They have to change for India. So I think that is the way forward. As far as these international streaming platforms go, of course, we would like to work with them. But unfortunately, we are not on Netflix or Amazon at the moment. And we would love to be on them. But you know, there's enough work in the market and there's enough people wanting to tell exciting stories. I don't believe in censorship. Yes, I do believe in certification. I do believe that, you know, there should be parental guidelines. There should be under 13, over 13, 16, over 16, 18, 18 with adult, you know. So I believe in that because, you know, I have a 13-year-old boy and there are certain things that I hope he doesn't see now because he's got to keep his innocence intact. So all your devices have parental guidelines to it, parental locks on it, child locks on it. So we should be savvy enough to do that, you know. And as far as censorship being imposed on it, if it's going to be the law of the land, it's the law of the land. What can you do? You've got to follow the law of the land, you know, and work within that. But that suppression or that kind of stifling will give rise to a new voice, you know, and maybe some more exciting content will come out. I see a lot of Hindi now, you know, I see a lot of stuff. I saw Rangbad, I saw Mirzapur, I saw, you know, Sacred Games, I saw Aparan. I've been following a lot of stuff that's been happening in India. No, I don't think the saturation has happened. I think it's just the beginning. It's just the start of the content industry, the streaming content industry. What we must understand is everybody's not going to watch everything. Somebody's going to watch more Netflix and somebody's going to watch more Alt, you know. So everybody's not going to watch everything. It'll get more and more curated, it'll get more and more fragmentized, you know. It'll get more and more localized, you know. More and more regional. And when I say regional, I just don't mean by language-wise regional. I mean by ethos-wise, you know. So it could still be in Hindi, but it's just centric towards a region, you know. So I think that will happen, you know. And different platforms will cater to different stratas or different aesthetics. Hi, this is Goldie Behl here. For all the digital entertainment updates, log on to digital hash.com.